Rav, please.
We are inside the law of Arvut. We advance according to it. Our whole life of how to is how to observe this law, whether we understand it or not. All of humanity is moving towards Arvut. And we can see this if we enter even 2-3 months ago. What's 2-3 months ago altogether in the life of a person? And we will see how much we thought and humanity thought about its development, its present and its future. And let's say in May, 2-3 months ago, yes? We will see the extent in which we've made a leap. We thought that maybe this will pass and we will go back to the life like before. Today we don't think that way any longer. Look what's happening to the entire humanity, to billions of people. What a revolution is transpiring in them. How they are changing their attitude towards life as they're in a certain process, a necessary process, and they have no choice, and it's not them who decide life, but rather life defines them. They're arranged that way and led and brought to another goal, and it shouldn't be like before. We are now in a process that we can, in a short period of time, to see the past and present and future, meaning this is already great attainment that each has in his life, where a person understands that what he had is not what we have and not what will be. And from this we raise ourselves, or nature, the Creator is raising us to another degree of reality, to another perception of reality. We are beginning, although, to be passive, but with Him together. We are with Him together in the same process. He is doing, nature is doing, and we are in the same process, and we also see the same process. It's before us. And we see that it's not us who are managing this world, and it's not us who can change it in regular things. But we even see that, God forbid, let's say, some bad future. We have no choice, but we are already understanding that this is that what needs to happen will happen. And from here already, the question is whether we can nevertheless make any difference, and are we willing to take on more and more conditions that the Creator places before us in order to change the future, never after all? Meaning we're beginning to be, although more passive for the time being, but participating, passive participants in a process that's before us, that's actually happening before our eyes. And we can also see this on the media, in people, in the families, in every place you go. It's a very big thing. And everyone is trying to lower their head and not jump up and not scream that, oh, I. No, we are in a flow that nature is defining. And the law of Arvut is deciding. People don't understand this yet, but it's going to enter more and more into the awareness that only through the right connection between us, we bring forth the good for us, and only through the lack of connection between us, the good connection between us, we bring forth the bad. These things need to be clarified still to everyone. And then we will see that this law obligates us, and we inevitably have to observe it. There are those that will do it reluctantly. What we call Beito in due time. And there will be those that will want to do it like us, in Achishena, in haste, meaning to bring it closer and observe it and keep it in advance, even before it comes and obligates us with force. We want to obligate ourselves to keep it practically in force. That's why we have to see day to day how we are all advancing. Our eyes are truly opening up in humanity. Less of these jumps that were from the different, the intellect and understanding that was happening and all that's occurring. And we will continue. The law of Arvut. There are here selected excerpts from the sources, because these excerpts specifically, these kind of juicy ones, the ones that stand out the most, are they should remain in us, with us, and help us advance more and draw humanity with us as well.